again to my YouTube channel. My name is Daniel and I'm the lead photographer at Mainstream Visuals. And today we're going to be talking about layers and insights. Layers and insights. How I edited this picture from this to this. Without wasting so much time, let's get straight into it. So, in this particular image, I shot this image sometime in February this year, and ever since I haven't really had the time to edit this picture. So recently I picked up this image and said, okay, I can actually create something with this image. So I went straight for it, and I'm basically going to be showing you in this video. This is by no means a retouching video, nor a dodge and burn frequent separation or color grade video per se, but it's just me showing you how I edited this image from start to finish. So let's get straight into it. So the first thing I did from this picture, I processed this image in Capture One. I literally did not do anything from Capture One in this image. And as you can see, the version of my Photoshop I use here is Adobe Photoshop 2021. Before I proceed, if you've not subscribed to my channel, kindly please subscribe, hit the subscribe button. And yeah, share this video so other people can actually come on my channel and watch this video. And please and please and please and please turn on post notifications so when I post a new video, you'll be the first to know. So I processed this image in Capture One, and from Capture One, I put it straight in here. I didn't do anything at all in Capture One. Like I said earlier, I didn't do anything at all in Capture One. So I'm just going to turn on this edited folder. As you can see, I already created the folder, edited. It's quite heavy. This file is quite heavy, so I did so much in it. So I'm just going to open this and go straight down to where I started. So I'm going to turn off all of this. So the very first thing. So what I did was that I noticed there were so many irregularities or flyaway airs and all this stuff around that air that I didn't want to be in my picture, that I don't like to see in my picture anyway. So what I did is that I took them out, and how did I do that? I used the clone stamp to wash them out. So I created a new layer. I used the clone stamp to take it out. So you can see before and after, before and after. You can see it's so obvious here. I'm very minimal around the edges of our air because I really didn't want I wanted the air to still look natural, because I knew obviously I'm still going to like do a little bit when I proceed with my retouching. So the next thing I did was that I had to fix a body. So you can see what I did in was that I opened my liquify panel. You can easily find that from filter, then this. So I use my liquify panel to fix that body. So you can see from this before and after. So I walked around bust areas and this, then the waist areas. I literally did a lot there. So I'm just gonna create a layer, then pop up here. Really name this, I like to give it a color. So I worked on this area, a bust area, I worked on this side, I worked on a bust, then just a little bit here to just straighten up, and definitely I worked around this. Remember I said I was going to touch this later, which I eventually did in my liquify. So yeah, so that was what I did there. So I'm just gonna delete this. And the next thing I did was the armpit fix. So as you can see, I fixed the armpit area, and I used the opportunity to also fill up this area that I created when I was trying to like frame my picture perfectly for Instagram. So what I did was, this is the armpit fix. And how did I do that? I did that using my patch tool. So I'm just going to show you a brief illustration on how this works. So I'm going to do Command J to create a copy of this layer, then zoom in a little bit. So this was basically what I did. You circle the area you want to fix, this dark area, then you sample it with, you replace it with a layer close by. So but eventually you do something like this and you see there's an overlapping area like this. You just circle this and do this. So you can see what I did there, before and after fixed. So that's basically what I did with the patch tool to fix the armpit. That was the first armpit fix I did. So you can see before and after. Then I did a second one to make it much more perfect. So I moved to a different layer to fix the armpit further. So the next thing I did here was pretty simple, and the basic thing we all know in photography or in beauty retouching, as the case might be, is that I did what we call, I opened my frequency separation layer to fix our skin. So like you know, in the frequency separation layer, what you do is that you separate, what frequency separation basically does is that separates the textures from the skin tone. So that's basically what I did. I fixed the skin, the skin, and I also fixed the areas that needed to be fixed. So you can see this, I did a little bit of extra work, turn this on and turn this off. You can see our face, how I made our face look much better than it was before. So after I did the frequency separation, what I did was that I went ahead to fix these areas that needed fixing. So I'm just going to create a new layer here so I can indicate with my brush. So if you notice this looks a little bit funny, and this looks a little bit funny, which is what I fixed. Can you see? Because I fixed using my, you know, the next Lipify panel I used. So I'm just going to delete this. So that was what I did. So the next thing I did after this was that I did my global dodge and burn, which is pretty much basic. I didn't do so much because you notice this image doesn't need so much of that anyway. So I did a very slight touch on the dodge and burn. So this is before, and this is the after. So you can see very minimal, right? So what I did finally was that I meshed the layers, which is this. So how to do that is pretty easy. For Mac users, I use a Mac, so that's Shift Command Alt E. For Windows, it's Shift Control Alt E. So I matched the layer, which is what we have here, and then I got a little bit creative with the image. I could have stopped it here. This looks pretty good. If I put in some lots or whatever in this, it's gonna look good. Again, for those who haven't purchased my presets, my camera raw, Photoshop camera raw, Lightroom presets, if you've not purchased it, you still have a chance to purchase it. I'm going to be dropping a link in the description that would lead you straight to where you can purchase it. So you can just go on the site and just purchase. It's really helpful because I'll be using that a lot in my tutorials, and you see how it works flawlessly on your images. So what I did from this, because I wanted to get a little bit creative. So you notice in the Photoshop 2021 version, there is a very interesting feature that we have here, and that's the sky replacement feature. So what I did was that I wanted to replace this old background with the sky and do a little further creative work on the sky. What I did was quite simple. I came here to my edit panel and I hit my sky replacement button. Now watch and see what's gonna happen. So now it's automatically selecting the sky for me and it's masking her out. Are you getting it? Has created a mask to take her out and replace the plain background with the sky. So what I did from here was that I just simply hit the OK button. Then I came here because I didn't like the way it was actually messing with our skin tone. I turned off these two layers. In other words, I could just use my command, select both and delete because I don't need it. So now I'm left with this, right? Now you begin to wonder how I got from this to what we eventually got in our final image. So what I did was quite simple. So there are so many tools in Photoshop that can actually help you achieve anything you want to achieve. So I came straight to my filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. No, sorry, I didn't use the Gaussian blur yet, but you can actually use the Gaussian blur. I think I'm actually tempted to use the Gaussian blur. So I'm just going to show you. Let me just eat the Gaussian blur first. So you can see, so if I increase this further, it further blurs the background. You can see how good this looks. So this looks less distracting. So if I had left it like this, what I noticed was that this would be so distracting because there's so much drama going on in the background. So I wanted it to look a little bit less distracting. So you can achieve that using a Gaussian blur. Can we take it further? So it looked like a very seamless gradient. This looks good, but that's not what I did. So filter, blur, and radial blur. Very strong tool, right? So you click on it, then you have the blur method, you have the quality of the blur, and you have the amount. So what I did is I increased this to about 28, then I used the spin, and on best draft, so let me increase this to like 40, so it's going to be a little more seamless. So I'm gonna hit the OK button, and you get the OK button, you're just going to wait for it to apply the blur. It's going to take a few seconds then. Okay, so as you can see, now we have our image. Look at before and after. So you can see I have successfully minimized the distractions on the background. So now we have a much more appealing look. She's standing out easily from the background. So that was basically what I did there. So after I did that, I meshed the layer again with Shift Command Alt E. Then I came straight to my filter. So now at this point it gets interesting because I created from the presets I put out for sale on my page initially. I created a preset for her because for those who have purchased the preset, you would understand that when you apply the presets on Camera Raw or Lightroom, there are adjustments there that you can easily adjust to fit the image you're trying to edit. So what I did for her was that I created a preset out of my my pack for us separately, so and you can locate that when you come straight to your filter, Camera Raw, then you wait for it to load. Then from this presets, you click on this, and I think I saved it Wendy because that's her name. So Wendy BW. So I click on that. If you notice, when you come here, you see how the adjustments are. Come to your color mixer, you see all what I did here. Then I didn't use vignette for this at all, so just click on the OK button. So good. So now what I did here was quite simple. So I could easily reduce this like 80%. Yeah, 80%. Yeah, so I'm just gonna delete this too. So let's just see, I'm showing you how I did. So I hit the grid here, then I come straight to the finishing of the image. Now this looks pretty good already. If I were to add my grain to this, this would look amazing. So it'll look amazing already, but I wasn't willing to just stop here. So I'm gonna turn on this final adjustment to see the final touches to what I did, and I'm gonna turn off all the layers so you can see how I came about what I did. So now the first thing I did was my curves, because I wanted to give it that very nice look, that nice feel. So then I eat some of my LUTs that I picked up. Now you can see what the LUT has done. I think this looks a little bit foggy, so I wanted to add that foggy feel, but still beautiful. So I gave it that foggy feel. I think there are a couple of those here. When you click on here, color lookup, you see it should be this foggy night feel. Yeah, so this is basically the preset I use here. So I gave it this foggy feel. I'm gonna delete this and stick to my initial group. So you can see, so after giving it that foggy look, I went ahead because I wanted to put some light in her face. So what I did was that I came to my curves panel here. You can increase this as much as you want it to be increased. Then you create a mask. Let me just show you how I did that. So what I did was pretty simple. Come here to my curves. Okay, I think what I should have done. Just take this back a bit. So let me turn this off. So what I did was I came to my curves, right? Then I increased the highlights from the center. But because I didn't want it to affect the whole image, I was much more particular about it affecting the face alone. I would use my Command I to invert this mask and use my brush, increase my brush, then put my flow at, let's say, 70. And make sure my brush is on black because I'm painting a dark mask. Then I paint through her face. So you can see it was created before. You can see the after. You can see it. So that's basically what I did. Yeah. So the next thing I did was that I applied my grains because I wanted to see the way my picture would look with the grains. So I applied my grain, and you can see how nice it looks already, but it's not really having the feel I wanted to have. So the next thing I did was I increased my vibrance a little bit. I added a little bit of vibrance to it, and just give it a little bit of that vibrant feel. So the next thing I went ahead to do was my curves again, because I wanted more light in the center. So then I went straight for my selective color, and just to give it now. So I wanted to pop out the skin here. So you note down your selective color, you can actually use this colors, you understand, select a color and work on that color alone. So what I wanted was for the skin alone to be affected, which is what I did. I reduced the cyan to add more reds, then added a little bit of yellow to it to make it look more like a light skin. And that was all I did here. So the next thing I did, let me zoom out, okay. I used my curves again to add some little light. Then the final thing was to add some vibrance to the overall image. So basically, I literally just used this final adjustment to finish up this image from this to this. So that was basically what I did in this image. And as you can see from the final image, we can now, to merge everything, just like I showed you earlier, Shift Command Alt E. Then that's it. So I've basically shown you how I edited this image from this to this. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you've not subscribed to my channel, kindly hit the subscribe button, like this video, and turn on post notifications so when I post a new video, you'll be the first to know. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Have a wonderful time. See you next time. Bye.